as he has been hailed by many.
Mimi, Daniel Taraitich Arap Moi.
Tough, principled, patient, impeccable timekeeper, gentleman. Those are some of the adjectives that have been used over the decades to describe Daniel Toroitich Arap Moi, Kenya's second president and one of the longest serving African leaders. Moi rose from humble beginnings on the slopes of the Kerio Valley to become one of the most influential politicians in Kenya. Just before independence in 1963, his close relationship with the father of the nation, Mzee Jomo Kenyatta, earned him the position of vice president, Kenya's third vice president. At that time, the self-styled professor of politics outwitted his political rivals to succeed Jomo Kenyatta in the top job, serving as president for 24 years.
Jomo didn't like to fly. And as a member, Kenya, as a member of OAU at the time, a member of the Commonwealth, a member of the United Nations, which needed the head of state to travel all those trips, it was Moi who was making them. Within the country itself, as a troubleshooter, to go and quell problems here and there, he was. I think he was an extremely effective vice president.
When the chance came, the Sharif Nasirs did not just spring out of the blue to say, we don't want an election. No, they had always been there and knew their man. They had always been there and knew a time will come when we'll play this game.
Moi's 24 years at the helm were marked by relative peace and political stability, economic ups and downs, and impressive political maneuvering.
I wish with humility to urge you to be loyal and patriotic to your motherland. This is my wish and prayer for Kenyans and the country I love most, peace and prosperity.
Daniel Arap Moi was born on September 2, 1924 in Sacho, Baringo district in the expansive Rift Valley. Moi lost his father, Kemoi Chebi, at a very tender age and was brought up single-handedly by his mother. At the age of 10, Moi joined the African Inland Mission School in Kabartonjo before joining Sacho High School. Born Toroitich Arap Moi, he took the name Daniel when he was baptized at the mission school. He then enrolled at Tambach Teachers College, where he trained as a teacher. Moi then went on to start a career as a teacher at the government school in Kabarnet, where he rose to the level of headmaster. However, his teaching career was rather short as he quit in 1955 to join politics. As a staunch Christian, it is believed that his decision to swap the classroom for politics came after interacting with a group of freedom fighters who were hiding from colonial forces. He is reported to have hosted the freedom fighters for 2 weeks. Sometime in 1950, Moi married a young woman named Helena Bomet, who later came to be known simply as Lena Moi. Over the years, the couple were blessed with 8 children, 3 girls, Jennifer, Doris, and June, as well as 5 boys, Jonathan, Raymond, John Mark, Philip, and Gideon. Moi's political star quickly rose and he was immediately elected member of the Legislative Council, LegCo, to represent his Rift Valley province, and 2 years later, he was re-elected.
He was mishandled in a coup, and he disliked that kind of thing, but that did not stop him from admiring the great values of what the British had, for instance. And that is why I think they refer to him as an Anglophile, someone who really admired the English way of doing things, the gentlemanly things that the English did.
In 1960, Moi joined another young politician from the coast, Ronald Ngala, and together they formed a political party, the Kenya African Development Union, KADU, ostensibly to challenge Jomo Kenyatta's Kenya African National Union, KANU, which was seen to represent the interests of the bigger communities, notably the Kikuyu and the Luo. On Kenya's independence in 1963, founding